Here on Kauai, I teach an ocean resources class called Ocean Pulse, where I go into the classroom and teach the students about what is on the reef, what the reef is made of, the algal species, the coral species, the fish, the invertebrates, and what a healthy reef looks like. Primarily, our focus has been at a small private school on the north shore of Kauai called Kula. And Kula started off doing Ocean Pulse in 1996 with Save Our Seas founder Carl Steppeth.
Oh, we took some kids out to the reef and we snorkeled around and we had a great time.
Many marine educational programs are book learning, whereas in Ocean Pulse, the students are actually immersed in the water and they become a part of the reef. Not only just seeing what it is, but actually knowing what's out there. And the more we can teach about the reef, the more we can research these areas that are being impacted, the better positive impacts we can have on our oceans. Generally speaking, we'll take out between about 5 to 20 students at a time. And that all depends on the class size and how many students are there at that particular day. And here then at Anini, we go out and we go snorkeling, and we have a lot of fun doing it. And that's one of the big things, is showing the kids that it can be fun to do science. Safety is our most important concern at the reef, and all the students are given a proper safety briefing. And then we have myself, as well as other teachers and lifeguards and other parents that come down and help us monitor to make sure everybody is being safe. And of course, we use the buddy system. The buddy system is when two students go out together and they are in charge of making sure that each other is safe. And also they can help each other identify reef creatures as they go. After the classroom, once we're at the beach, the students get on their snorkel gear and jump in the water, and we go out and we check out what is going on the reef. There are few educational programs like this in the world, many because of liability, and with public schools, it's really hard to get students involved and in the water. So we have a unique opportunity here on Kauai to immerse students firsthand. I've been teaching at Kula for the last 4 years, and this is the first time the 7th graders have actually had a marine science class. Usually it's the 10th graders. But we also have classes from kindergarten to 6th grade also, and that's a real treat to see the young ones in the water doing the same kind of monitoring the high school students are doing.
I'm Christian.
I'm Jesse.
Jake.
Chris.
Harley.
Got all our equipment today. We've got video camera.
This is a underwater digital camera, and we're gonna be shooting footage of fish and marine life today.
We've got still cameras, we've got PDAs, which are personal data assistants, little mini computers.
This is a fish surveying clipboard. This is what I'm gonna be surveying today.
This sheet lets us identify some of the corals, hard coral, soft coral. We mark the coral every half a meter.
As you can see on the sheets here, you could circle that, and just by circling that, that would indicate that we've seen that species. We could also put tally marks next to it, which would indicate how many lobe coral heads we see. I expect to see kind of our average species that we see, a lot of sea cucumbers, a lot of urchins, world famous sap-sucking sea slug, one of the sacoglossans that inhabits down here. We have sometimes we see thousands of those in one dive. Got a really nice conditions today. Just a little bit of wind, a little bit of current, but the water's really clear, so I'm expecting a great dive today.
We're gonna switch off. Me, Christian, and Jesse are gonna switch off.
We're in a digital media class, so.
Over a 3 or 4 year period, I participated in a project and a class called QUEST, Quantitative Underwater Ecological Survey Techniques, where college students learn to monitor the reefs through going down and taking down notes on the reef, as well as video monitoring. I participated in the first year of QUEST and then returned as a team leader to help other students learn about the reef and how to monitor it. Right now, what I'm doing here on Kauai, Ocean Pulse, has changed a little bit, and it's closely modeled after QUEST. So the students are actually well aware of this. I explain to them that what they're learning is some of the same things that college students are learning. And when you tell a kindergartner that, that tends to get them pretty excited that they're learning some of the same things that college students are learning. Most of the local population responds very well to Project Ocean Pulse because it's based actually around a set of Hawaiian principles. The Hawaiians had their island divided into pie-shaped sections called Ahupua'a. And the Ahupua'a was a section of land from the mountains all the way to the sea where people that lived in that area would take care of their whole section of coastline. And we try and talk about that concept as well. Not only is it the ocean, but everything that you do on land affects what happens in the ocean. It's so interconnected. Save Our Seas Project Ocean Pulse could easily be exported to other coastal communities and island areas where students learn about the reefs, their own reefs, in their backyard and learn to take care of them. Things that they do at their homes affect the reef, and then they in fact can teach their friends and their families about ways to preserve, protect, and restore our reefs for future generations. I think it's very important for Ocean Pulse to be used in other islands, especially islands like Oahu, where there is a greater population and we do see more impacts from humans and human cities. So it's of utmost importance to get this knowledge out there as quick as we can. We live at a time now in human history where the population is growing by leaps and bounds, and if we don't do something quick, it's going to be too late.